Alrighty guys, as it continues into the Dragon Ball Legends TOP walkthrough video, this is going to be part 2 of 2 for the standard edition. If you guys are looking for the pocket edition, that would be linked in the description down below. Alright, so last time we left off right here at the boss fight, everyone's in great condition. We actually got some friendship ranks up, by the way. We got this guy to friendship rank 10, this guy to friendship rank 10, and this guy to friendship rank 2, which isn't that significant, but I definitely want to get him up to 10. Alright, so coming off of that boss fight, going to the right of us, 4-5th stage again, this is God Key with Whis. Alright, so I think this is the team formation we're going to use right here. We're going to have our EX Purple on the backup, and then as well as our red, just because there's the two blues right here. This is also, it can be risky because of the three purples. This guy's gonna go ahead and swap out, or he's gonna tag out, right, since he's a tag unit. But then the blues, he's gonna kind of be screwed right there because he only tags out one time. So definitely do keep that in mind if you're running a similar team to me. All right, so for attack order, I'm gonna go for Whis first. That's the most important unit since he's gonna stun you on turn two. Then after that, we'll go for the blue Vegeta, the purple Goku. We'll go for the blue Goku, and then the purple Vegeta right here. Do keep in mind that dude does mitigate a blast arts. We're not running a blast team, so don't really have to worry about that. And then the red Goku at the end. All right, so that one actually was very easy. Our attack order was perfect for that, especially it helps out a lot because this guy had a super attack, so we were able to take out Whis turn one and then get this guy significantly weak to the point where Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken ulted or super attacked the purple Goku. Alright, so next is to the right of us, 3-5th difficulty fight. This is a high tier fight. This is where it starts ramping up as indicated by the orange coloring on the pathing right here. This is Vegeta Clan. This is the team formation we're going to use on this fight, so you want to bring out your high tier characters. We do have the Kid Gohan, and we have the tag units, as well as our Goku right here. So all three of our boost units, the double S tier plus the Z tier, you do want to start bringing them in now. I'm going to go ahead and save this guy on backup. That way we can get a super attack for a powerful opponent fight. He's going to get that 20% instantly, and then we'll put this guy on backup as well because it's a double blues, and we avoid the middle row because the EX Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta is going to be debuffing the middle row. Alright, so the first unit we're going to go after here is going to be the Sword of Hope Trunks because he has a strike cover for the Sweater Trunks. Then after that, we can safely target the Sweater Trunks, who has a universal cover change for the tag Vegeta slash Trunks. And then we will go for that guy. And then after him, we'll go for the Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta. We'll go for the Free-to-Play Trunks and then the green one at the very end. So I'm not going to lie to you guys, we had to use the rush right there, which is a little bit sad considering the fact that it's a 3-5th difficulty fight. Still 2.7 million, we got the full kill, everyone's in great condition right there. We didn't really have the firepower, if I'm being real honest, going into that one. Alright, so next is fight 16. It is going to be to the right of us. It's against the God Key Whis again. Alright, so this is the team formation we're going to be using right here. This is going to be easy fight, so don't really have to sweat using super attacks here. I mean, if I could, I probably might just save this. I'm not sure. I feel like, nah, we'll use it. So attack order is going to be same as last time. We'll go for Whis first, want to avoid the stun overall. Then we'll go for this guy, we'll go for this guy, we'll go for the Goku, Vegeta. Remember, he nullifies one blast arts and then the red at the end. Alright, again, pretty easy fight right there. Really, really straightforward. 4.1 million, and we did get the full kill. Alright, so next is straight above us. It's against this Androids fight. This one can be a little annoying, I guess, but just because the units are not ancient, but it's a 3-5th difficulty, so shouldn't be too much of an issue. Alright, so this is the team formation we're going to use right here. We're going to keep saving the super attack right here from the Beast Gohan. That red 13, he does count as a powerful opponent, so I don't want to waste that just yet. This fight's not going to be too difficult, right? We're avoiding the middle row because of middle row debuffs provided by Gamma 1, actually. But I think this is going to be fine overall. All right, so first unit we're going for here is going to be the Gamma 2 because our Goten's going to super attack him. Then we'll go for Aider because he has a strike cover for Gamma 1, who is going to be our third target. And after that, we'll go for 13, 14, and then this 15 at the end. That 15 does have, like, debuffs, I think, upon, like, when you kill him. So does Aider, but the units that he's going to be buffing are not going to be too strong, except for the Gamma 1, right? Okay, I did make a little bit of a mistake there. I mistaked Gamma 2 for 1, which I guess my brain is just turned off. Still a good fight, though. 4.2 million. We did get cover changed by the Android 8, but it's okay. All right, so next is to the left of us. It is a 3-5th difficulty fight against Super Saiyan 4s. If you are a blast-based team, I also included an alternate pathing to which you're going to be going towards the right-hand side up here. So kind of have an easier fight for us, but we're going for this one for sure. All right, so this is the information I'm going to be running right here. I genuinely think that running the blues is going to be a bit of a risk factor. Like, I know there's the red Vegeta. If this guy had super attack turn one, I would do it. But I think, I'm pretty sure you only get 3% at the start of the first turn. right? So 3%, he wouldn't be super attacking on turn 1. It'd be on turn 2. I think this is going to be better overall team formation. We'll see how it plays out, though. I'm not sure. All right, so let me start this off by saying that the yellow Super Saiyan 4 Goku has a cover change, or cover rescue, for Gogeta 4, the green Super Saiyan Full Power 4, and then the purple Super Saiyan 4, and then the Tag 4s have a strike cover for the yellow Super Saiyan 4 Goku. So we're going to go for the Tag unit first, and then we're going to go for the cover rescue unit, and then basically what we're going to do here is we'll try to get this purple unit out of the way. We'll get the red, this green Full Power Goku, and then Gogeta at the end, and we're probably going to have to use a rush for him, honestly. So I'm not going to lie to you guys, that went great. It went amazing, actually. I think that was 100% the move to take off Taunt Hunt. With 5.9 million, we did get the full kill. We didn't even need the rush. I know it's only a 3-fist difficulty, but that's impressive to me considering the units had 3 EXs on the board and only basically one guaranteed super attack to work off. This Goku did get a super attack, though, so that helped out plenty. All right, so next is straight above us, 3-fist difficulty fight. It is against the Mohawk Squad. All right, so this is the team formation we're going to be using right here. Backup members Beast Gohan as well as the Goten right here. I don't want to bring in double purples because of the double yellows, and then we are going to avoid the bottom row because the blue Zamasu is going to be debuffing this row. Attack order is fairly simple right here. We're going to go for the Nappa first because he's debuffing every turn. And then we'll go for this yellow Oob. This guy, our red attacks last, right? So I think that's just a no-brainer for us. And then we'll go for this Tapion. Hopefully just super attack him with a Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken, get him out of the way. And then we'll go for another yellow. And then the blues at the end, starting with the Nappa and then the Zamasu. I definitely put too much faith in these guys, if I'm 100% being honest with you. I really thought we were going to be able to get this guy on turn 2, or well, I guess at the end of turn 1, and then super attack this guy with their Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken, but that definitely was not the case. Either way, still turned out fine in 3-fist difficulty. I just put a little bit too much faith in the damage output right here. All right, so next is straight above us. Once again, 4-fist difficulty fight against Godkey with the likes of, there's Hit and Frieza here too, so it's a little weird. All right, so this is the team formation we'll use right here. Double greens. I'm gonna put both of these blues on backup, actually. I know Taunt Hunt, you guys might be screaming at me, why am I taking Taunt Hunt off, but I think this will be a good team formation right here. Let's see how it plays out for us. And let's try to get the Beerus at first, and then the Kaioken Goku. Remember, Beerus will stun you turn 2. Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken will stun you turn 2. I'm not too worried about Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken, because even if we don't kill him turn 1, I know my Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken is going to be faster than this one, right? So we're good on that aspect right there. And then after that, we will go for the Golden Frieza. We'll go for the Hit. We'll go for Vegeta. He nullifies one Blast Arts, by the way. And then Godku at the end. I would say that was pretty perfect, honestly. Taking off Taunt Hunt for the extra damage was huge for us there. We did get the full kill. We were able to kill Beerus and then get this guy practically one-shot at the start of turn 2. And thankfully, our Goten is faster than a Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken at the moment. So he was able to get the final blow. And then Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken was able to super attack this guy. Next to the right of us, it is against the Super Saiyan 3 fight alongside Shallot. This is also a pretty easy fight. All right, so now I'm basically going to be saving this super attack and then this super attack for two specific fights in general. And so this will be our team formation essentially. We are going to be having this guy with a super attack. That'll be helpful for us there. And then this guy he's getting the board wide buffs, right? Or not board wide, but for my entire team, he's basically buffing. And then this guy's buffing up the purple Gohan right below him. All right, so for attack order, I want to go for the red first, low key, just because we have the Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken in play. And then after that, I think we go for this guy, super attack him with our EX, Kid Gohan. Then we'll go for the blue unit. We'll go for the yellow. We'll go for Shallot and then purple. All right, so we definitely messed up. A little bit of a yikes moment right there. 5-fist difficulty fight. We still got the full kill. Got the rising rush kill, unfortunately. I forgot that the green, he had a cover change or a cover nullification, or not, no, a cover rescue for the red Super Saiyan 3 Goku, which we did go for him first. So he got cover rescued, and then our Gohan finished him off with his super attack, which was supposed to land on the green Goku, plus we got that stun turn 1. So turn 1 was basically completely and utterly wasted. I'm surprised we even got the full kill, if I'm being real honest with you. So next is to the left of us, 4-fist difficulty fight is against this, kind of a free-to-play fight with Shallot. Shallot is still a free-to-play character too. And we are just going to be continuing to do this team formation. This Goten's in a really nice spot right here. And we're going to keep using this team formation, basically. I like where this Goten at. He's in a really optimal spot for him. And then I like this. He's giving buffs to the Taunt Hunt right there. This guy's going to get a super attack to this fight, probably turn 2 or 3. And we're looking good. That being said, first unit we'll go for is going to be this Kefla. And then we'll go for this Trunks. and then we will go for the Vegeta, since Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken will probably super attack him. And then we'll go for the Gohan, Shallot, and then Goku at the end.
All right, pretty easy fight, pretty straightforward fight. No rush needed to get that full kill. 10 million points, by the way, and we are looking pretty good.
And next is to the right of us, three-fist difficulty fight. It is against Godki. And same team formation. We're just going to let this guy build up his super attack. This Gohan's going to, well, obviously this Gohan's going to be getting healed by, both of the Gohans getting healed by the Green Goku. And these guys are still waiting their turn to get their super attacks off. And we're going to be using the same attack order, so we'll go for Beerus first, and then the Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Goku. Beerus has a stun turn 2, Goku has the super attack on turn 2. And then we will go for the Golden Frieza, we'll go for Hit, we'll go for Vegeta, has a Blast Nullification, by the way, and then Godku. Alright, pretty good, pretty easy fight right there, right? Three-fist difficulty, 9.6 million, and we did get the full kill. And we have super attacks built up, this is huge. Alright, so next is to the right of us, three-fist difficulty. It's against a powerful opponent. This is why we've been saving the super attacks though, right? Alright, so this is the team formation I'm going to be using for this fight. There's double yellows, so let's go ahead and take out one of our purples. And alright, so this is the team formation I'm going to be using right here. We'll save this super attack. We'll save this super attack for the final fight. This guy, or not this guy, this guy's getting a guaranteed super attack because of all the powerful opponents. Plus, he automatically turns it into the ultimate, which is going to be really, really helpful here. All right, so attack order. Before we go into the attack order, let's talk about what these guys do. I think I've already stated this before, but the LF Full Power Frieza, he debuffs your whole team turn 2. Has a blast cover change. We're not too worried about it, but blast cover change for LF Broly, LF Jiren. Bojack blue cards you turn 2, but he has really low key restore speed, so at the end of turn 2, realistically, LF Jiren stuns you to turn 1. Nothing you can do about that. Does have a strike cover change for the LF Broly and the LF Free, or LF Full Power Frieza. And then the Sparking Full Power Frieza, as you guys knew, know, he nullifies a Blast Arts, and then upon nullifying it, he gets 100% to his blue card. Right, so you have to kind of take him as your first unit if you're running a blast based team here. And then the LF Broly has a strike cover for LF Jiren. This fight is just a technical nightmare. But that being said, we will go for Frieza first, and then we'll go for the Bojack Jiren, the Sparking Full Power Frieza, the LF Broly, and then free to play Broly at the end because he's kind of just here. All right, so coming out of that one, again, like I said, technical nightmare, 11 million points. We did get the full kill though with a rush on a 3-5 difficulty fight and with a starting super attack with our Beast Gohan that turned into the ultimate arts. Plus, he's getting the buffs from this guy. Like, it's rough, right? We got 2 super attacks off in that fight. 2. All right, but for the last fight, we are going straight above us. It is a 4-5 difficulty fight against the Buu Saga. Remember how we built up all these super attacks too? Like, this is perfect. We're going to put both of these blues on backup right here, Tauntaun and the Beast Gohan, since, I mean, there's no reds on here. I'm not too worried about it. This guy has a guaranteed super attack coming up. This guy maybe could get his super attack. He's at 27%. I don't think so, though. Goten guaranteed super attack. This guy guaranteed super attack. This guy guaranteed super attack. We should be able to just nuke this fight, honestly. All right, so for attack order, I'm going to try to super attack this guy. Well, we are going to super attack him, hopefully kill him. Then we'll go for the Boo Boys. Also, do remember, the Ring Super Saiyan 3 has a universal cover change for the Blue Majin Vegeta. And then we'll go for both of the yellows, starting with Angel. And then this guy, he does have a buff against regeneration. Do keep that in mind. Then we'll go for the Majin Vegeta Blue, Majin Vegeta Purple at the end. All right, so coming out of that one, we did still need the, even with all the super attacks, we still needed the rush. And we did get the full kill, thank God. 16 million points is huge. That's massive. Everyone in great HP condition too. This team is so easy to use. It's actually ridiculous how easy to use this team is. Let's just take a look at the HP. Let's go ahead and see where we lie on the leaderboard before we close out the video. So number one player currently at the time of recording is rocking with this Universal Survival Saga kind of team. It's a little bit wonky. Has Angel Vegeta right here. We do know he was placed in S tier. That Bardock is Z tier right here. So a mixture of Saiyans slash Universe reps. Okay. And then as for our ranking, we're sitting at rank 3,302. I think that's really good. I'm really happy with that placement right there. Again, this was a very easy team to use overall. Did you guys rank higher than me? Did you guys rank lower than me? Let me know in the comment section down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Later!